थिंक आई टेल यू वन वन कंफ्यूजन और दैट आई ऑलवेज यूज टू हैव व्हिच आई यूज टू व्हिच आई एक्चुअली गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ क्लैरिटी लेटर इन माय लाइफ वाज व्हेन आई वाज स्टूडेंट व्हेन आई वाज इन आईएमटी आई ऑलवेज यूज टू थिंक फाइनेंस एज अ बिग बजवर्ड वेयर एवरीबडी इज लाइक चेजिंग फॉर फाइनेंस करियर्स एंड wherever it is written whether it is core finance whether it is non core finance it used to kind of sound very attractive that hey I want to work for a core finance role but what does that really mean right I think most of the whatever you have to do in finance roles ultimately comes from understanding of the business understanding dealing with people having the right kind of sales skills, having the right kind of marketing skills, and using the right kind of intellect. So I think understanding of business, how the business, how dhanda really work, is the most core principle of finance. Okay. While people can learn a lot about future and options and DCF models and those thick books about finance, but I can tell you the ground reality of finance is understanding the dhanda very well. So my strong advice to everyone is. When you think about finance, try to learn some kind of expertise into certain sectors, certain industries, how literally thing works, right? For example, one of the very strong attributes which is required for, let's say, a role like us is just to be extremely aware about things. The most important function as a finance professional is to connect the dots. You'll be able to connect the dots if you are aware about everything that is happening around you. Be it marketing, be it HR, be it IT, the role of finance professional is to connect everything and make those numbers work magically. So I think just kind of knowing the right kind of formulas and being an Excel wizard doesn't make you a finance professional. I think just kind of having the right kind of dhanda business sense and being very aware is extremely important. That's what becomes, and see, this is going to be a tough time for next 6 to 12 months is going to be a tough time for everybody, especially looking out for new job opportunities. But I can tell you all these business cycles kind of go through this ups and downs. After 6 to 12 months, again, opportunities will start looking up. But one should use this opportunity to kind of do a lot of upskilling. And by upskilling, I don't necessarily mean that, log on to some digital course and take some digital certification. By upskilling, I reiterate, it means that know about a subject matter in detail. Take any subject matter, go deep into it, know everything about it. There has to be two or three subject matters which you expertise on, which you know in and out about those particular sectors, or even that how something particularly works, right? That's when you are able to apply those skills into your work when you are really kind of needed out there. So I would strongly suggest that, especially candidates who are coming out of a B school, it's extremely and you all will be under some kind of a managerial role, right? Where you will the most important skill will be to kind of dealing with a lot of people. Those soft skills will be extremely important. So I think those are some things which are typically undervalued, underestimated. I think those are the things which I would urge everybody to work on.